called a horse. She got in a horse.
I would think.
Okay. Shh, I'm gonna be happy to. Thank you for asking so nicely.
Me.
Sit down. Sit down. All the way down. All the way on your fanny. That's a good boy. There you go. And this isn't bug juice. Gotta stay on your fanny.
Sit. Sit. Stay.
Bobo.
Bobo. You gotta stay sit.
You want it? Sit down. Jackson, sit. Sit down. Sit down.
Uh-oh.
He says, okay, I'll come over here. Okay, so anyway, for some of you older people, here's the thing. Dragonflies may have as many as 30,000 lenses in each eye. Painted ladies, the butterfly, painted ladies. Does it need more cut off? Squeeze it out from the bottom. Up. Here. Miles. Catch. Put that on the bottom so it won't. Okay. Painted ladies, which are some pretty butterflies that we see.
Not bad.
They actually migrate from Africa to England over 3,000 miles.
Wow.
And, I mean, butterflies.
I can see
butterflies. The largest moth is an owlet moth that lives in tropical America. It has a wingspan of 18 inches. A moth that big? Woo!
Mommy, he wants more animal catchers.
Cockroaches can run a foot a second.
Can what?
Can run what?
A foot a second. There are more than 10 billion ants in the world.
I think they're all at my house.
No, I got a few. The good bugs are ladybugs, praying mantis, because they're and the decomposers. You know, one of the reasons why bugs are good, Miles, is because even the nasty bugs, help decompose dead stuff. Can you imagine if the dead stuff never rotted, if there was never anything taking it away, if it was always just laying there, all the dead stuff would pile up and there wouldn't be, everything would be around to be dead. So it's really good to have bugs that take care of dead animals and plants. So that's why that's really good.